Hello students, in this class we learned the exercise 8.3 problems. These problems are based on profit, profit percent, loss, loss percent, simple interest and percentage ratio. So let us start our exercise. This is exercise of NCERT book. So let us take question number 1. In this question we have to find, tell what is the profit or loss in each of the following transaction. Also find the profit percent and loss percent in each case. So let us take first part. Garnick shares bought for rupees 250. So here 250 is the cost price of the material and sold for rupees 325, and this is the selling price of the material. So here we see that cost price is rupees 250 and selling price is rupees 325. So as we know that cost price is less than selling price, or we can say selling price is more than cost price, then profit occurs. So here cost price is less, selling price is more, so profit occurs, and profit is rupees 325 minus rupees 250, that is equal to rupees 75. So here in this transaction profit is rupees 75. Now we have to find profit percent. So we know that profit percent is equal to profit upon cost price into 100. So we can find profit rupees 75 on cost price rupees 250 multiplied by the 100. After calculation, we can find that in this transaction the profit percent is 30%. In this way, we can solve next other problems also. Let's in question number B, a refrigerator bought for rupees 12,000. So 12,000 is the cost price and sold for rupees 13,500. So 13,500 is the selling price. Here again cost price is less, selling price is more, so profit occurs, and we can find profit by subtracting cost price from the selling price and profit percent in the similar way. Similarly we can do other questions also. Now let us take question number 2. In this question, we have to convert each part of the ratio to percentage. Ratio is given and we have to convert each part of the ratio to the percentage. So, for converting the part of the ratio to the percentage, first of all, we have to convert the parts of the ratio in the fractional part. So, let us take the example number 1, in which the ratio given is 3:1. So, we have to find total parts, the whole parts of the ratio, that is 3 plus 1 is 4, and we can solve this question like that. If we see the solution here, total parts of the ratio are 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. Now 4 is the total part, first part is 3, so fractional part is 3 upon 4 for first, and second part is 1, so fractional part for second is 1 upon 4. So we can write this ratio 3:1 in this form, 3 upon 4 ratio 1 upon 4. Now if we convert the percentage fraction to the percentage, we simply multiply it by the 100 and we get the percentage of parts like that, 3 upon 4 into 100 ratio 1 upon 4 into 100. So percentage of the parts is 75% and 25%. Here we can check our answer also by adding these percentage, 75 plus 25, the total must be 100. The total must be 100. Here we can cross check our question also. Similarly, if we have to find the percentage of each part of the ratio 2 ratio 3 ratio 5, then first of all we have to find total parts, that means sum of the all ratios, all parts of the ratio, that is 10. Then we write the all parts in fractional form, that is 2 upon 10, 3 upon 10, 5 upon 10, and simply multiply each part by 100 to convert each part in the percentage. Now, next is question number 3. In question number 3, the population of a city decreased from 25,000 to 24,500. We have to find the percentage decrease. So here, initial population is 25,000. After some time, due to some reasons, the population is decreased to the 24,500, and we have to find percentage decrease. Before finding the percentage decrease, we have to find the decrease, actual decrease in the amount, and we solve this question like this. The decrease population in a city from 25,000 to 24,500. Population decrease is 500. This is decrease in population. So decrease percentage is population decrease upon original percent, original population multiplied by the 100. So 500 upon 25,000 into 100, the result is 2%. So here the total decrease in the population is 2%. We can solve this question in this easy way. Now let us take question number 4. Arun bought a car for ₹3,50,000. Here the cost price of the car is 3,50,000. The next year the price went up to 3,70,000. The price is increased and it will next new price is 3,70,000. What was the percentage of price increase? As similar to question number 3, in question number 3 there is a decrease and in question number 4 there is a increase. So the both questions are same. So first of all we find the increase in the price, then we subtract 3,50,000 from 3,70,000 and the increase becomes 20,000, and then find the percentage in increase by getting 20,000 divided by original price 3,50,000 multiplied by the 100. This is our required answer. Now next question is, I buy a TV for ₹10,000 and sell it at a profit of 20%. How much money I did get it for it? Now the cost price of the TV is ₹10,000 and here the profit percent is 20%, and we have to find the selling price of the TV. So we can solve this question like this. The cost price of TV is 10,000. Profit percent is 20%. Now profit is equal to profit percent of CP. First of all we find how much profit we get on the sale of the TV. The profit and loss always depend on the cost price. So The profit is equal to 20 upon 100 into 10,000, and 10,000 is the cost price. So here the profit is 2,000 rupees. Now selling price is cost price plus profit. So selling price is 10,000 plus 2,000, which becomes 12,000. And the amount which we get on sale, so on the transaction, is 12,000 as a selling price of the steel. Now let us take the next question. Question number 6. Juhi sells a washing machine for ₹13,500. Here the selling price of the washing machine is 13,500. She loses 20% in the bargain, and the amount she loses is 20%. So the loss percent is given here, 20%. What is the price at which she bought it? And we have to find the cost price of the washing machine. So before finding the cost price, we have to find that. We can do the question like this. Selling price of the washing machine is 13,500. Loss percent is given 20%. We have to find cost price. As we know, loss percent, loss and profit, both are depend on the cost price. So let us take the cost price of the washing machine to be X, and loss is loss percent of the cost price. So in this case, loss is equal to 20 upon 100 into X, that is 2 upon 10x. This is loss. Now we know that selling price is equal to cost price minus loss. In case of loss, the selling price is less than cost price, so we have to subtract the loss from the cost price. So selling price is 30,500 is equal to X minus 2X upon 10, that is 8X upon 10. So X is equal to 30,500 into 10 divided by 8. And after simplification, we get our answer. So we solve this question in this way, that selling price of the washing machine is 13,500, loss percent is 20%, let the cost price of the washing machine be rupees X, and loss is loss percent of cost price, that is 20% of X, is equal to 20 upon 100 into X is equal to X upon 5. Now the selling price is cost price minus loss, therefore 13,500 is equal to X minus X upon 5. This represents 13,500 is equal to 4x upon 5. So after transposing 4 upon 5 in the left side, we get x is equal to 13,500 into 5 upon 4 is equal to 16,875, which is the required cost price of the washing machine. See here, one thing we must remember that always cost, profit and loss, both are always depend on the cost price of any item. Now let us take next example. Question number 8. Amina buys a book for ₹275 and sell it at the loss of 15%. So how much does she sell it for? Here the cost price of the book is given, loss percent is given, and we have to find selling price. So the question is very simple. First of all, we find the total loss on this cost price, and then we subtract the cost from the loss from the cost price and get the selling price. Now the next question is based on the simple interest. So let us take question number 9. Find the amount to be paid at the end of 3 years in each case. In first case, the principal is ₹1200 and the rate is 12% per annum. So let us see the question. So here is the principal is ₹1200, rate is 12% per annum, and time is 3 years. So the simple interest is principal into rate into time upon 100 is equal to 1200 into 12 into 3 upon 100, that is equal to ₹432. This amount is simple interest. So we have to find in the question the total amount. So amount is principal plus simple interest, that is 1200 plus 432, which becomes ₹1632. Similarly, we can find in case of question number B also, here principal is ₹7,500, rate is 5% and time is again 3 years. So simply apply the formula and calculate it. Now we have to take question number 10. At what rate gives ₹280 as interest on a sum of ₹56,000 in 2 years? Here ₹280 is simple interest, ₹56,000 is principal, and 2 year is time. We have to find rate. So we know that simple interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. So we simply put all these three things in this formula and we get 280 is equal to 56,000 into rate, which we have to find, into 2 divided by 100. After simplification, we get that rate is equal to 280 upon 1 upon 4% per annum. So we get the rate is equal to 1 upon 4% per annum, or we can check the question here also. Here principal is 56,000, simple interest is 280, simple interest, we have formula of simple interest is principal into rate into time upon 100, we put all the things here and simplify, the rate is 0.25%, that is 1/4% per annum. Similarly, we have a question number 11 of simple interest topic. The question is, if Meena gives an interest of rupees 45 for 1 year at the rate of 9% per annum, what is the sum she borrowed? What is the sum she borrowed? Here we have interest, simple interest rupees 45, time is 1 year, and 9% per annum is rate, and we have to find principal. So simply we write in the formula like that, simple interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. After simplification we get that principal is equal to 45 into 100 upon 9, that is principal is equal to rupees 500. So in this way we can solve our problems based on profit, loss, simple interest and other topics. I hope you understand each problem. So practice more and more questions by yourself. Thank you. Have a nice day.